Hello everyone, welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know about this video, watch the video till the end and please press the like and the subscribe button which is given, the bell icon that is given below. Today we have a topic with us that is called the SUMIF Excel function. Now this is a part of the math functions that are given in the Excel. Now what exactly this topic is all about, that's what we are going to discuss today. Now, before directly jumping on the example part, I want you to understand what exactly this function is all about. See, is basically a built-in function. It's a built-in function in Excel. And the Excel SUMIF function is categorized under the math functions in MS Excel. So SUMIF in Excel, that adds all the numbers. It basically adds all the numbers in the range of the cells that meet the specific criteria. So it can be used as worksheet function in Excel, where it can be entered as a part of a SUMIF formula in Excel worksheet cells. Now, how does this exactly works in Excel? See, the SUMIF formula is something like this. If you just enter is equal to and write SUMIF, so you will get something like this. It adds all the cells that are specified by a given conditions or a criteria. So the SUMIF formula in Excel has three arguments. If you just press a tab button, you get range, criteria. Now, this SUMIF formula in Excel has three arguments, as I'm saying. The first one is range. So this is the required parameter. The range is basically the required parameter. It indicates the range of the cells that the criteria are to be applied against. This is a lookup range on which the criteria are applied. Then you have the criteria. Now this is the required parameter and it is the condition to determine the cells from the given sum range. And then you have the sum range and this is an optional parameter and it indicates the range of the cells to be summed together. So if no value specified, it refers to the first parameter, that is a range as a range of cells to be the sum. Now, how to use the SUMIF function? Very important question. The SUMIF in Excel worksheet function, it's a basically, again I repeat, it's a worksheet function, and as a worksheet function can be entered as a part of the formula in a cell of worksheet. So well, let's look at a SUMIF Excel examples and you know we'll get a really more insightful analysis on this particular formula. As you can see over here, this is the total amount of different brands. You see there is a brand of Panasonic, LG, Samsung, Onida, Whirlpool, and so on and so forth. And in front of the brand, there are number of equipments and the prices of those equipments that have been mentioned. Now the total amount, I want to find what is the total amount that I have spent on the TV part. Well, in this example, if you see the first, let's first enter the formula here. We'll write the SUMIF. Now when we enter the SUMIF formula, we have to select. First, we are going to select the entire range, and this is the range that is B2 to let's go till, yeah, it's fine, B2 to B11 or B12. Yeah, I think it's B12, yeah, comma. Now what's the criteria? The criteria over here is TV. So I want to determine what is the total amount that I'm spending on TV for different brands. Let's say you are doing a business and you have number of brands, and for that number of brands, you have number of equipments. So you want to find what is the total amount of cost of production for you that you want to make for in terms of TV that you have purchased. So what is the sum range? So I'll say the sum range is from C2 to C12. So now I'll close the bracket and I'll say I got 1,98,000. A moment, if I deduct this, the value will be gone. So I'm saying to the Excel that sum if only the data, only the numbers that fall for TV as an equipment. Well, In this example, the cell over here, C14, has a SUMIF formula of Excel that is associated with it. So C14, this basically is a result cell. So the first argument of SUMIF in Excel is B2 to B11 and is the range on which the criteria is to be applied. Then the second parameter is TV, which means it looks for cells having value of TV that ranges from B12, B2 to B11. And the third parameter is C2 to C12, and which is the range of the value that is needs to be added. So there are three entries that is to be satisfied: first, second, and third. So the sum of the values from this C4, C7, C10, and C12 will be performed, and we will get an answer of 1,98,000. Let's go to another example and try and understand the different angle for this particular case. Again, the same thing: the brand, equipment, and the prices. Now we want to try and calculate how much of the amount that I'm spending for the non-branded one. So I'll start with and say that sum if the range that we'll start from is A2 to A12. What's going to be the criteria? The criteria, I'm saying that I don't want any branded. So wherever there's nothing mentioned is the non-branded one, right? So I'll just press double without writing anything here. So closed apostrophes, and you see the sum of the range here. Close the bracket, and when you do that, you get 53,000, and it's just the addition of both of this. As you can see, 53,000 is the answer. Here it is specifically written that it's TV, so it includes branded and non-branded, everything in totality. So in this example, the C14 has a sum if formula Excel associated with it. So C14 is a result cell. The first argument of sum if function in Excel is an A2 to A12. The range on which the criteria is to be applied is the second parameter, and that is the apostrophe that which we use, and which means looks for cells having blank values in range of B2 to B12. And the third parameter is C2 to C12, which is the range of the values that are to be added. So there are two entries that satisfy the given criteria where no brand name is entered in the cells. So the sum of the values of C11, C12 would be performed, and which is 53,000. We'll go with another example here. It's quite simple. Now, non-branded spend and all the brands that you are spending. So here, I'll simply say is equal to sum if all the brands. Okay. So I'll open up my bracket. I'll say A2 to A12, comma. The criteria is going to be, let's say, apostrophe, and we'll use less than and equal to. So this is to signify that everything in all the cell, wherever there is a letters or probably the name that is mentioned, that is branded one, and where there is nothing mentioned, it's a non-branded one, just to signify. And the sum range is going to be the price. Close the bracket, you'll get 3,27,000. So try and add this. See, this is the answer, 3,27,000. As simple as that. So this two will be completely eliminated. Let's take the last one. Sum of all the TV and the fridge. So here, I'll start with sum, not the sum if. I'll start with first as sum. Inside sum, I'll use a sum if function. The range over here is going to be, because we are talking about equipment here, comma, the criteria, we want what? TV, comma, we want fridge. The data for TV and fridge, close the bracket. The range criteria is this price, right? The range criteria is going to be the price. So once you do that, so here we'll use different bracket here inside this. Ha, see, there we go. So we have to use a curly bracket here to add two different equipment here details. So when we do that, we get an answer for 2,77,000. Now, if you want to verify that this is correct or not, we'll try and do that. Let's calculate for TV and fridge. See, it's 2,77,000. We have got the exact answer that we need. So this is how you calculate. Now, there are a couple of things that you need to remember. See, when a sum range is not provided, it refers to the range parameter. Okay. And that is the value of the range of the sales to be the sum. Second, the numerical criteria. The numerical criteria need not to be enclosed in the quotation mark. Third, the text criteria, including the mathematical symbol, needs to be enclosed in all the mathematical symbols that needs to be located, denoted in the, with the different commas, apostrophes that you can use. And any sort of wildcard characters, such as question marks, or probably, you know, the asterisks that you use, can also be specified in the criteria, where the question marks is used to be used to match a single character, whereas, you know, star is used to match any series of the characters. Now, to use the above wildcard characters as literal ones, the same needs to be preceded by the title operators. So this indicates, you know, criteria as question marks. So if you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.